Thank you, Michaela. Tomorrow marks 6 years since a Jacksonville woman was found dead inside her home. Bradla Cook was the mom of three, and she was the grandmother of 10.
The Jacksonville Sheriff's Office is now putting the spotlight back on this case in hopes that more information will come in. Here's Katie Jeffries now, who leads our Unsolved series featuring local cold cases.
Bradla Cook went by the nickname Bee with her grandchildren. She loved cooking, gardening, and of course her family. But in 2015, a burning car would lead to a terrible discovery. And since that moment, Bradla Cook's daughter has said they've been waiting for answers and justice. With a big smile and holding on to her grandbabies, Kara Trimmer says her mother radiated love for her family.
My kids' favorite memories with her was going yard sailing, as they called it. They would just go shopping for garage sales together.
But the making of memories came to an end on October 28, 2015. Jacksonville Fire Rescue responded to a burning car near Hyde Park in Ellershaw on the west side. The tag number came back to Bradla Cook, so officers went to her home just over a mile away on Harlow Boulevard, and they walked into a brutal scene. Bradla was dead, killed by blunt force trauma and knife injuries. Detective Ray Reeves with the cold case unit at JSO is re-examining this case. He says the attack on Bradla wasn't random, it was personal.
There were no apparent signs of forced entry. It didn't appear to be a burglary.
Detective Reeves says while they don't have a motive in this case, they do have persons of interest and recently submitted DNA to the Florida Department of Law Enforcement for more testing.
We've had the ability to work down genetic genealogy lately on some of our cases, and so we're hoping that something with that physical evidence will bring us a resolution to this.
But investigators could use help from the community, especially those living near the two scenes. Anything they remember, even little details about that night, could be a break in the case.
Someone walking by, or I heard a sound, even a time frame that could give us something. The cars or someone in that neighborhood at this time would be very, very beneficial.
Trimmer says she is encouraged that the cold case team is looking at her mother's murder, because with the case still open, her family can't fully grieve.
The frustration and the anger that it has been, not only for me, but my children and my family and her friends and her church. You can't put that into words.
She hopes anyone with information about her mother's murder will do the right thing and give the family the justice they deserve for a grandmother who still had decades ahead of her to make memories with her grandchildren.
We just don't want it to be one of those cases that people forget about. I know it's been 6 years, but for those of us that work cold cases, there are no statutes of limitations. There's no time that we won't go back and look at cases.
If you have any information about the murder of Bradla Cook, or if you think you know anything that could help, contact the Jacksonville Sheriff's Office or Crime Stoppers. Katie Jeffries, First Coast News, on your side.